90 days. Our first 3 months of full-time RV living. And we're going to give you a little insight to some of the things that have happened to us.
The good, the bad, the not planned, the plans that didn't go as planned.
We bought the RV, we had it inspected. It was in Colorado Springs, Colorado. And it was in February, in the middle of February. And so the inspector said, you got a good unit here. And he told us about the little problems and that kind of stuff. And we got on an airplane and we went to Colorado Springs to pick her up.
And it turns out it was the coldest day in 123 years. Negative 15, I think.
Negative 15.
Of course, the RV had a hard time starting.
So that was our first uh-oh moment. And when we finally figured out that the diesel fuel and the fuel filters were frozen solid, we got some fluid to put in the diesel fuel tank. We went out and bought some new fuel filters. We figured out how to put them on, and guess what? Started right up after that.
3 days later.
Yeah.
So again, a little bit of stress there.
A little bit of stress, and it was very cold working underneath an RV for that long. You know, from there, we had a couple rules. You know, we had some things that we said, these are the things that we want to do.
Or not do.
Or not do in this case. And one of the rules of not doing was we did not want to drive our RV in the snow.
Right. Now, I've lived in Philadelphia all my life and never, lots and lots of snow and never liked it. Driving in it was my one rule. I never drive in the snow. So here we are, 3 hours into the trip.
We leave Colorado Springs. We're about 3 hours outside of Colorado Springs and it doesn't snow. It is a squall. I mean, it was a whiteout. Everybody pulled over off the road. We had to get off. It was incredible. I mean, I've never seen anything like
now,
it.
Now, for those of you who don't know and haven't, this is the first video you've seen. It is a 40-foot RV with a tow car.
So we're about 55 feet long when it's all said and done. We're about 55 feet long. And anyway, it was interesting. We took a few extra hours to get home that we didn't plan on.
Right.
But it's always better to stop.
Exactly. So we stopped. We took our time, and we were coming in to a Boondocker's welcome.
Yep.
And rule number two, never pull in after dark. And so here it was that first night, 10 o'clock at night. Lucky for us, we met the greatest couple for the Boondocker's welcome. That was in Albuquerque, New Mexico.
Neil and Marianne, they are the greatest people in the world. There's a video that we put out, and you know, if you go onto our channel, or we'll put a link to it down below. But I gotta tell you, Neil and Marianne are just incredible people.
Absolutely.
And they've become really close friends. We've already, you know, we're only 3 months in and we've already seen them twice, and we already have plans to see them again later this year.
Yes, yes, so they were great. Okay, so we've had other rules that have been broken, but you know, let's move on to some of the other things. So as you said, there were things to be fixed. And then there's things to be organized. We've organized, reorganized, organized, reorganized. And I think we're in the fourth time of organizing and reorganizing.
You know, our friend Cindy came over the other day, and I felt bad because she came over to watch a video that she helped us produce, and she's sitting in the RV, and we had cables and wires and boxes all over the thing. So it was just really...
Yeah, you have to pull things out to be able to figure out where things go. And I think we're doing a pretty good job. Our RV has lots and lots of cabinet space.
Yeah.
So now it's a matter of containers, but we are in the process of, again, organizing.
Now, I just want to say before we move on a little bit that Patti's thing is sunsets. She just loves sunsets. And where we are in Pennsylvania, we have these chairs and we sit actually where the camera is right now every single night, and we watch this beautiful sunset behind us. So I've tried to tune that camera up so we can get some of the colors and see it as we're going through the evening. But, you know, let's talk about when we got the RV home and we had to make some modifications to it.
Yes. Yes. So the first thing was taking a couch out to put a desk in because Dan needs an editing suite. We have a video on that as well. Dan had an office with two desks and six or seven monitors,
yep.
large monitors, and he did take it down to two monitors and one desk.
Two monitors, one desk. But the desk goes up and down. It's really nice. You know, for those of you who haven't tried those desks that go up and down like that, it's really great to be able to stand up and edit sometimes, because sometimes I'm 4 or 5 hours at the desk, and it just, you know, that's not a good thing.
Right, right. So a lot of videos and a lot of editing.
Now, another thing that happened was that we took one of the RV couches out, okay? And Neil and Marianne's son, he told us that we could probably sell that people would buy it.
Right.
So Patti, the Facebook marketplace person that she is, she posted
put it up on Facebook.
We sold that thing.
Yes, we did. Yes, we did. So we had taken it apart to take it out, and somebody came and bought it, which was great to see it go to good use.
Right.
So we spent, and again, we have a video, about 30 days in Lake Mead. And that was our kind of home away from home. It was about a half hour, if that, from the house that we moved out of in Las Vegas, because we wanted to get used to the RV. We had some business to take care of. So we're in Lake Mead for 30 days. And there were no hookups.
No hookups.
And I think that was also a rule, but I think you've forgotten that rule. So no electric, no water. We could go get water and fill the tank.
However, the previous owners were very diligent in what they did. So they put the Freon or the coolant antifreeze into the fresh water tank. And boy, was that a bear to get out.
Right. So
we had to flush those tanks, what, eight times?
Yeah. So not only no hookups, but we moved the RV. We couldn't even make it through 4 or 5 days without moving it to empty it, rinse it, refill it. You know the drill. So that was challenging. And
at best,
I think I did very well not having electric, not having, you know, water all the time. I think I did pretty well with that.
Pretty well. Well, we learned a lot about the RV in those 30 days. And we strongly recommend, if you're getting new to RVing and you just, you know, are getting out there, go someplace close to your house and spend a week.
Yeah.
You don't need to spend a whole month, but spend a week. And
we thought a week, but after that first week, it was like, okay, I could breathe. I know where things are. I know how to operate things. So really, a month might have been too long,
right.
But I like that we had time there. But then we were getting itchy. It was time to get moving.
It was time to get moving. So after 30 days, we started ourselves across the country. And again, we did a video on that. So there's a video of the 8 days that we took to travel from Las Vegas to Pennsylvania. Right. So we'll link that down below as well if you're interested in seeing all of our exports. But I'll tell you what, I have to say, for a 2002 Monaco Diplomat, now our unit's 40 feet long, we didn't really have any problems coming across the country.
No.
This thing loves 65 miles an hour, and we just shot down the road. So we were very, very pleased with that. There was some areas on Route 40 that terminated a few of our plates.
That actually happened when you decided to go to the dumb station without really...
Right. You know, there were some plates on the counter, and I said, they'll be fine. We're just going 100 yards away.
Yeah, to the dumb station. And a plate catapulted across the RV. Now, but that also taught us, because this really, really rough road, I could hear the glasses. I thought they were... in there pretty good, but I could hear the glasses in the cabinet, and I just thought, they are broken. I'll just accept it. We'll buy new ones. It is what it is. But actually, when we got to our destination, they weren't broken. So I was pretty surprised. But again, organizing, finding ways to secure. Anybody have suggestions, put it in the comments of how to secure the plates and bowls and dishes and glasses. Some people just use plastic.
Well, you know, we that bought four new. I like a large milk glass, okay?
Yes.
And we bought four large milk glasses, and they were really, really nice. I think we got one left.
One left.
90 days, we're down to one.
One.
So maybe we ought to go to the plastic. And our friend Frederic, he showed us some really nice on his houseboat. He's got some really, really nice
plastic
pieces. And, you know, can we talk a little bit? I know we're talking about that, but talk a little bit about the people that we met while we were in Lake Mead. There, you know, some friends, I believe, that I think they're going to be lifelong friends.
Absolutely. And there's a video.
John, if you're
that.
Watching right now, I'm talking about you.
Yes. And Terry, of course.
And Terry,
and
yeah.
There is a video on that. We'll link below. It's really interesting being in a state park we were in.
Right.
Like Mead's a state recreational center.
Right.
It's called something else.
It's national, but that's okay.
National. Okay. Correction. And people were coming in and out. There were some people there for a week or 2 weeks or 3 weeks. And it was amazing the people that we met and how great they were.
And you know what,
get together at night.
Oh, yeah. We'd sit around and we'd tell stories at night. We'd have a question of the night. This is John's thing, where we would ask a question and everybody would answer that question around, like, tell us about your first girlfriend or some or boyfriend or, you know, something like that. It was really... I loved it, and I miss them.
Yes.
I wish that we were back with them, and we already have plans to be with them in January of next year. So we're looking forward to that.
Right.
But yeah, it was really, you know, one of the things about RV lifestyle, it has to be the nicest people in the world. I mean, everybody is nice to everybody. Everybody talks to everybody. You know, we've met some really great people. We've met some other YouTube channels. You know, Adrian was there for a couple days, and he's big on TikTok, and he's big on YouTube. And it was really great to sit and talk with him for the evening and his wife. And he had a photographer there with him. Mm-hmm. So it was really great to meet those kind of people.
And that is what's really nice. And, you know, they're different. Types of when we RV across the country, we've done different things, and we'll get into that. Boondocking, moochdocking. We were at a winery, so we have the harvest host, boondocking, all of those things, and the different things lend itself to different types of interactions. You know, here we are on a farm now,
yep.
So I fast forward, and you know, we're here with a friend, so that's been awesome. Spending time. But the one thing I want to go back, and I want to, when I was thinking about this whole idea of RVing, I thought, what do people do all day? You know, we have a YouTube channel, so we're shooting video. You're doing a lot of editing. I can't say I do that. And, you know, we're working out of the RV, but there's a lot of time. What do people do? And I thought about it probably 2 months ago. I was sitting in a chair. Actually, I think I was talking to Terry, and I said, I just don't feel like moving. It was a sunny day. We were just watching, looking at the trees, looking at the, you know, things flying around, you know, the live, you know, living things flying around. And that's what you do. I didn't want to get up.
I know.
And you realize an hour passes by. And I said to her, I said, well, when do you clean? Because we were hanging out. And then we go in when it was time for bed. And she said, yeah, you clean when you're ready to leave.
You know, go to the next place.
You clean to go to the next place. So,
you know, it's also the sense of community. You know, our friend Pat, who is part of John's, you know, tribe or group, that they kind of travel a lot of different places together. But he has a Georgetown, and he put Battleborne batteries in there, and he had a problem when he put his solar on because it was not a sealed box. His battery box was not sealed, so he got water in there, and some of his switches and solenoids started blowing out. So, you know, John, who was an engineer at Boeing, said, well, we can fix that. And a bunch of us all got together, John and Pat and Steve, we all got together and we got underneath this thing. We went up to the hardware store and we built in this box all together. I just love that. It's just great to be able to be a part of, you know, people that just really care about each other.
Right, and willing to help. And you see it a lot, even on the groups. You mentioned one of the Facebook groups, and you just, you see that sense of community. There are a lot of RV, full-time RV groups. There's, we have a Monaco, so a Monaco RV group. Yep. So you could type in, hey, I'm having problems with the water heater, which was a problem, and they'll tell you what to do. And it's just, you know, people are just wanting to help each other.
It really is incredible. And I can't thank enough. I'm losing his name. I'm sorry. Neil's son in the fire chief.
Tim.
Sorry, Tim. I couldn't think of your name there in a second. But Tim has been such a help to us. He's got a 2002 Monaco, not a diplomat.
Right.
He's been such a help. He, you know, sits and he talks to me. And if I got a problem, he'll, you know, get on the phone and talk to me about it. So, you know, people like that. The only problem I have with Tim is his RV has a slide out on both sides.
Okay, so here's our next thing. Let's talk about that. So when we bought the RV, cabinet space, the storage space was really important. The refrigerator was at the top of the list. But I want to talk about a couple things here. First, we bought this RV with the idea that we'd have it for a year, figure out what we like, what we don't like, and then we'd, you know, buy up. We'd go to the next
upgrade,
thing
to
upgrade. So I always thought that the refrigerator being on the passenger side, never liked it in the front, but it had to be on the passenger side, was the greatest thing in the world.
The kitchen.
This RV, the kitchen is on
the driver's side.
The driver's side, and I wouldn't have it any other way.
I know, it's
Why?
Great.
Why? Because when I'm sitting at the kitchen table, looking out, I'm looking out at what's really our front door, our front.
Right.
So, you know, we stopped the one time we're sitting and having lunch, and there was like a beautiful meadow with cows, and it was great. You know, to sit and look at the scenery. So that was something that was very important. But let's get back to the slides. So Tim, thanks a lot. We were just there as we came across the country, and we go into his RV and he pushes out all the slides, two of them in the living area.
Wow.
So now this is what Dan wants.
What a difference. I mean, you know, when you live in something and again, We have continually downsized since we moved to Las Vegas. We had a 7,000 square foot house in Las Vegas, and then we moved to a 3,500 square foot house in Las Vegas, and then we moved to a 500 square foot RV.
And a lot of people correct us and that it's nowhere near 500. So yes, we this is what we're telling ourselves.
We just tell ourselves it's 500.
Yes.
But that extra space is like really a big deal. So we probably are going to be retiring for us Explorer One probably sooner than later. Not because we don't love this unit, not because we don't love the diesel, not because we don't love everything about this unit, because we really do. It's just, I think that extra room is going to be really important for us, especially having an office and working full time and shooting the way that we do all the time. So that's probably something that's going to be in the cards for us very, very soon.
Right.
I
think the message here, though, is be careful what you go and look at. Like, we are supposed to go to Quartzsite when they're having the big RV extravaganza. I don't know what it's called, but anybody who's in the RV community knows what it is. So I'm a little worried about you going in those new RVs, I got to say.
It's going to be a problem. So anyway, in that first 90 days, the last 20 days or so, we have been here in Pennsylvania. And we are staying in paradise. Is it anything but paradise?
Yes, it really is. And it's really incredible. Again, I was born and raised here. And, you know, you see old houses, old Philadelphia. That's just what I knew. Going out to Las Vegas, the oldest thing there is, I don't know, 30, 40, 50 years. Maybe they're no old. So coming back here where we are, the house is from 1744. And every time I walk in there, I mean, I'm just in awe. So
I know, and the walls are like this thick, and it's just so beautiful in this barn here. I mean, and they don't really use the barn anymore for anything other than storage, because this farm is no longer a working farm.
Right.
and the history of this farm, I can tell you, 20, 25 years ago or so, I came out to this farm and met our friend Cindy's father, and they had belted Galloways. As a matter of fact, there's still a sign right off camera over there of the belted Galloway area. And I was just so amazed at these cows. But the other things we've been able to do here too is, you know, Cindy's brother is a woodworker. And
amazing.
I mean, the stuff that this man makes is just incredible. I mean, nothing less than absolutely incredible. Now, we've done a video on that. We'll link it down below. I'll try to put it up above over here, too. But sometimes that doesn't work for me real
right.
well.
Okay.
But you know, you got to see what this guy does. Right. And you know, like the axe handle. You actually made an axe handle into a chair.
yeah,
into a bench.
But the best part, again, we are Moochdocking, and the best part is spending time with Cindy and her family. We had dinner with her sister and brother-in-law, and it has just been great. I see what people do now all day. They talk, you know, it's just been great. She's been over
here.
Funny. She's running the camera.
She's running the camera for us. She's running the camera at the video we did on the organic farm, which we're going to be doing a lot of stuff on that coming up. But it was funny this morning. She came up from the farmhouse up to where we were, and I guess we were eating breakfast. We had sourdough pancakes this morning with eggs from the farm over top. And she's like, boy, you guys really have a great life. I want this life. That to me is, you know, what it's all about. And
right.
I just love everything that we're doing. We're producing videos of all these interesting places and people, and it's really been an experience. This is 90 days. My friend Frederick De Silva, he's a headliner in Las Vegas. He's got this great show, and he bet me that I wouldn't make it a year.
Oh, wow. I didn't know this.
He bet me a dinner in France. Mind you, he's from France. So
well,
he bet me at a dinner at a restaurant in France that we wouldn't make it a year. And
Do I get to go with?
You get to go with.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
All right, then. Yeah. And somebody said that. As a matter of fact, at dinner last night, Cindy's brother-in-law said, so is it getting tight in there yet? And look, it's a small space. If I'm in the bedroom and he
right.
wants to come into the bedroom, I have to move. It's a small space. But, you know, when you have this outside, and
yeah.
it's actually a little chilly right now.
It's getting a little chilly as the sun goes down.
Just like the temperature that out here, we've
right.
spent a little less time outside. You know,
we're shooting this in May, like the middle of May, by
yep,
the way.
Yep.
So,
it's not getting tight. It's because
how's
of
that
the
sunset?
Idea.
That looks good back there.
Because
I hope it's looking good in the camera.
Because I think it's not tight because of the idea that this is also our living space.
Right.
And when you can embrace that. Now, we've been here for almost 3 weeks. Thank you, Cindy and her family. And I'm getting a little antsy where I want to take a trip somewhere.
I know. It's like, where do we go?
Yeah. So I guess that's when you know that RVing is for you.
It's funny, though, too, that our health coach back in Las Vegas, Jen, she's got all these places. When we get there, she's going to fly and meet us. And I think Cindy's kind of getting the itch a little bit too.
Yep.
It's like maybe she's going to like hop on board or stow away in the back when we go to one of these.
Yeah. Now, I want to talk just for a minute about sourdough because that was a challenge.
Yeah.
I wasn't sure. We have sourdough starter, which somebody gave us.
No, I started it from scratch.
We started from scratch, which is a little iffy. Sourdough is something we're allowed to eat on our health program. And being on the road, that, you know, eating has been a little bit of a challenge.
Right.
We're getting there. But I wasn't sure the sourdough was going to make it. And, I mean, you'll have to show a picture of the sourdough pancakes.
Yeah.
It's really thriving. So here's what I'm going to say. If you see us on the road, come, you know, visit us and we'll get you started with sourdough starter.
Really, you know, and because it's like a growing living thing.
Yes.
And a lot of our friends back in Las Vegas have our sourdough starter. It's matured for a little over a year now. We've had the sourdough mm-hmm. starter and it is just going strong. I got to tell you, the sourdough pancakes that I had this morning are to die for.
Well, I made those.
Yeah, you made them.
It won't happen again. I don't do any of the cooking. So I guess we're being very honest here. I do very little cooking, but I did make those.
But I'll tell you, they were absolutely, absolutely incredible. We have a recipe for sourdough cinnamon rolls that are better than anything that you have ever eaten. I'm telling you, they're so good. You just got to try these things. But
and yes, our health coach approves.
Their health coach approved because they're sourdough.
Yeah, I think we've gone down, you know, a road.
Well, you know their health coach approves because every time I made them, somehow or other, she figured out that I made them and she was at our house that night.
Yes, that is true. That is
all right,
true.
So we are running out of time. Is there anything else you want to jump in real quick?
No, there's so much to talk about, but I think we've covered a lot for today.
Wait, I'll tell you, go ahead.
Don't forget, if you like the video, subscribe. Hit the bell. You know the deal.
Yeah, you know, and Cindy, who has a bigger YouTube channel than we do, just said, wait, you better hit the bell? Yes, you have to hit the bell.
Because
that's how you'll get notified when we put up new videos.
And certainly we love likes.
Yes, and we love it. But more than that, more than subscribing, more than bells, more than all, you know what? We love your comments. And we do read them. We get back to everybody. I think we really get back to everybody that makes a comment. So if you have something to say, if you have a suggestion, if you see that I'm doing something wrong, let me know. And we would love to hear from the listeners. So I want to thank everybody for the support that they've given us in this first 90 days. We had goals and we have not only achieved the goals that we had, we have surpassed the goals that we had set for this first 90-day period. So we're really, really happy about that. So from Lansdale, Pennsylvania, I'm Dan Hunt saying have a great rest of today with my incredible wife, Patti, saying...
And a better day tomorrow.